It hides behind closed doors, in the homes of individuals, or on the streets, in cars, in factories, in the fields, on small fishing boats, and in many, many other places as well. It happens in cities, it happens in villages. We find it in the richest of countries and in the poorest countries in the world. And the worst thing is that this situation, unfortunately, is growing worse day by day.
At no point did Islam condone slavery between the people whom it deems as being equal, equal from the same father, Adam, and the same mother, Eve.
قربات التطوعية إلى الله عز وجل لمن أراد أن يتقرب إليه.
The emancipation of slaves as one of the greatest acts of worship which pleased God. God Almighty has spoken the truth. Human beings, in accordance with the nature and purpose of procreation, are equal. No one has honor over the other except by piety.
Dignity was given to human beings by God, one of his greatest attributes. And there can be no dignity without freedom. All of the goods stem from freedom.
And it is certainly blasphemous and hubris to reduce any one of our brothers and sisters, irrespective of gender, race, and age, to a single aspect of the mystery and destiny for which they were created by the living God. The body and productivity of others are not ours to own. They are only ours to respect and treat with dignity.
I'm attaching an appendix to the statement in which I further develop this petition based on international and Jewish law for all forms of slavery to be considered crimes against humanity.
Human trafficking is an open wound on the body of contemporary society. It is a crime against humanity. It is the duty of each country to implement laws that work towards eradicating this extremely cruel and immoral crime and to liberate and protect victims from such a fate. We need to awaken their latent courage and self-confidence to help them arise. They need to realize they are not helpless and vulnerable like kittens. They are mighty and courageous lions. We have to help them elevate their minds.
But what can we do? We can make sure that every worshiping community of every faith knows about modern slavery and is ready to work to prevent and put an end to these abuses. We can look to our own actions and choices as consumers and users of financial services, whose managers can put great pressure on companies in which they invest. We can make sure that those who have been enslaved and trafficked are supported, respected, and welcomed into community. We can continue to press governments to implement more effective laws to root out these evils. In the United Kingdom, the Modern Slavery Bill is currently going through Parliament and is a very good model. We can work with the business sector across the globe to ensure robust systems for slave-free supply chains.
We should not do this work as cavaliers sole, as alone warriors. The root of modern slavery runs deep. And the cause and condition, the networks and structures supporting it are complex. That is why we need to build a community that can continue this work to protect human life.
We are inspired by our faiths, and we have joined together here for this historic initiative and also for very practical action. We wish to declare that we will work together to eradicate the terrible scourge of modern slavery in all its forms.
This is an unprecedented demonstration of faith leaders of the world coming together to draw a line in the sand to end the scourge of slavery. We ask each of you who have spoken here today in this room or witnessing this around the world to share their common conviction that systematic removal of liberty to exploit another must no longer be in this world, as we collaboratively draw together to end this crime against humanity.